So I've been pushed in the deep end and have been dragged to the Wave in Bristol, the UK's largest surf simulator, where I've come to address the trauma of grief.
What doesn't kill you can make you stronger, not will make you stronger. I think what doesn't kill you can just leave you horribly wounded. One of the main things that grief does is it creates a shock effect, which means you detach from the body. So we have to find ways to heal and reconnect to the value of loving life.
Josh runs Resurface, combining surfing with counselling for trauma resolution.
Therapy, Josh.
Yeah.
Especially therapy that might be tailored for someone who's been through a traumatic bereavement. I tend to think of that as two chairs around a low table with a box of tissues on the top. So why are we surrounded by surfboards?
Surfing is becoming a go-to activity for people's mental health. One of the reasons that actually therapy is much more than just conversation. We hold ideas in our mind, but it's our body that holds the trauma,
yeah.
The impact.
So, I mean, I found when my partner died, yeah. My sleep was completely disrupted and I've never really got a sleep pattern back. And that has obvious physical consequences.
Yeah. We can't think our way out of trauma, but we can act our way out of trauma.
Which sounds great, but we're here in February and the idea of surfing in this weather is traumatic in itself.
I mean, at the moment, I'm feeling quite apprehensive about this because it's involving lots of things I don't want to do. Okay, yeah. I don't want to get cold, I don't want to get wet, I don't want to fall over, I don't want to look like a walrus dressed in a space hopper. And all these things are about to happen.
When you're apprehensive or anxious, you're releasing a lot of norepinephrine or adrenaline. And that focuses the mind. So we need to have that apprehension to get into the zone of what we're doing. When you're out in the water and focused on this single goal of trying to stand up on the wave, you cannot think of anything else. And that is a respite from your grief, your anxiety, your worries, and just, I almost guarantee there's going to be a smile on your face, either because it's over, but also that sense of I've just done something outside of my comfort zone, and I've survived, and maybe I've learned something about myself.
Well, he talks a good game. I guess it's time to stuff myself into a wetsuit.
You're not coming, really? No way. Well, it's very wet, it's very stormy. Surf's up, so is the vicar.
As I'm faced with a foreboding tsunami, I'm reminded that people often describe grief as oncoming waves that we have to master. But that is easier said than done. Although with a little practice, anything is possible.
You're now a surfer.
Well, you know, 60, overweight, arthritis in both knees, about to retire. It's a good time to start doing stuff like this. It was fantastic. It was exhilarating. And you're exactly right. You are completely involved with what you're doing and trying to figure out how to catch this wave, how to stay out of the water, how to stand. There's so much going on.
And that sense of mastery of being able to do that, it's like I'm regaining some control over my grief.
That was a hugely rewarding thing to do in itself, but also a sort of violent physical thrill doesn't work for me. That's not what this is about. This is about elemental challenge, and then all of a sudden it's about this extraordinary experience of being lifted up. That's what this is about. So it's not a fairground ride. It's a lot more than that, actually.
You know, from Richard today, he was buzzing when he came in. Now, if you can capture that and integrate that into therapy,
people are much more willing to do the work. That allows an opening up. Even just to start with, just acknowledging that I am grieving, instead of just saying, I'm fine, it's okay, don't worry about me.
I know a lot of people, men in particular, find it very hard to open up. And doing something like this could be just the ticket. And if it's helped me, it could help anyone.
How do you think David would have responded to something like this?
He'd have loved it, yeah. He would have been mocking me ruthlessly. One of the things I miss most about him is he made me do stuff I wouldn't otherwise do. And I feel parts of me withering for lack of that. It's one of the worst things, actually. It's this feeling of you become diminished as a person because you've lost the person who made you more than you are, you know?